Got something from overseas. It's from a W. Van Helven. Oh, okay. Hey, let's see. Let's see what it is. Oh, wait a minute. Ah! I'm just kidding. Oh boy, my wife loves things. Pam,
yeah,
something
yeah,
has come
what's
from
going on?
Overseas.
Oh my! Another box.
Another box.
Here, here's the scissors. Okay. I've been cutting. Security. Who's this from?
Well, I don't know. But it's from the Netherlands. Or,
oh,
as we
wow.
like to say, Holland. God, I love Holland. I still
All
have
tulips.
Some of my daffodils. Yeah, well, my tulips, I went over there.
Here we got tulips.
Bought a bunch of tulips and daffodils. The tulips, though, don't last. They only last about 10 years. But the daffodils, oh my
Could
God.
You write a letter to the tulip manufacturer?
Look at all this.
Oh! Oh! Cookies! A mug!
Dear Todd, my name is Winchico Van Helden, and I'm 37 years old and from the Netherlands.
Whoa!
Last year, I actually stumbled across one of my movies on YouTube, one of your movies, when I was searching for pinball-related movies. See? People watch my videos, Pam. Ever since I'm a regular visitor on your channel, of course I subscribed. Yes, you're one of 11,520, I think I'm up to. I love to see the great job you and your crew do on the arcades, pinballs, etc. I'm hoping to see a Williams Hyper Ball or a Bally Rapid Fire one day in your videos. If we ever get one traded in, I will. That would be great. Unfortunately, they're hard to find. Too loud, perhaps. Actually, the Hyper Ball broke down all the time. The Rapid Fire held up.
Come on. No,
okay, anyway, because
stuff.
Of the great
we
videos
got.
You made,
Let's
I would like
it.
To give you and the crew something back. I've included two packs of
cookies.
Stroopy waffles. Pronounced Stroop waffle. It's a waffle made from two thin layers of baked dough with a caramel-like syrup in the middle.
That sounds yummy.
It's like a waffle cookie.
I hope you and your crew enjoy them. Of course, your lovely wife.
Oh, I get one too. Yay!
I'm going to
try one too.
He actually says lovely. Look.
Thank you.
Lovely wife and two daughters.
And two daughters. They're lovely.
My lovely
too.
Wife. My lovely wife. I think
and they're lovely
just
too.
Brought up their lunch.
They take after.
I mean, they're going
to
eat their lunch.
They brought something after me. And look.
Besides this troop coffee waffles, I've also included a can. With
coffee.
Deluxe. This is the only can in here. With deluxe, I lost my place. Stroop waffles, some Dutch licorices, and a pack of Dutch coffee. Yes.
This is coffee here. See? That's coffee.
Douillet Gierbert's
aroma
rude. It's rude aroma.
Yeah, you are rude.
You're
rude. You'll like
look
that.
Look, jams. Look. There's a bunch of them.
Oh!
Wait a minute.
Oh! What kind?
Let's see.
Strawberry.
Strawberry. They're
strawberry.
Perfect.
We love strawberry.
Wow, this is really
That's
nice.
That's my favorite.
I would be thrilled to see you drink the coffee
and
out of the mug
this?
I've included.
Vanilla drops. Cookies. These are candies.
Candy. We're going to have to translate.
Oh.
Here's the mug. Look. You'd like to see me drink. It's a mug which has our national anthem written on it and a little surprise when you lift it up.
Dark
it
chocolate.
Sings the Dutch anthem.
Oh.
I wish you, your wife, and the entire crew all the best and keep up the good work.
Do you have
well,
the words
thank you
for
very
me.
Much.
The words.
Actually, we will have this today at our party. I'm,
good
we,
idea.
You
have the candies
like,
and cookies.
I'll tell you what.
Plates.
We're
going
to translate some of the language. So I can read it back to you. So let me get this ready, and we will come back. But first,
put it on. I want to hear it.
No, we're going to see it later. I'm going to first take it back here because we have to show you this 8-ball deluxe. Oh. This guy is going to have a stroke if he doesn't get it. All right, here we are. 8-ball deluxe. One of the greatest games ever made. This one, though, is very special. Because this one has a brand new overlay, courtesy of Classic Arcades, Jeff. There's the link.
Beautiful. It went down fine, but actually, it took some time, Frank.
This game didn't look like this. Actually, cleverly, I have some footage I'd like to share with you.
Actually, look at this work in progress. This is getting a new overlay. So we had to take everything off the play field. And this has to get sanded down. Frank! Wait a minute.
It's not powdered sugar, don't eat it.
Sandpaper and yeah, get in there with whatever it is that you want it.
Yeah. Now look what Jason has done. He's taken off all of Bally's paint, haven't you?
Yeah.
It's gone. It leaves a beautiful wood surface, doesn't it?
You're leaving it like that, right?
Yeah, you know, I think it looks pretty nice this way. And we could write on here like 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Now, Jason is cleaning the hole out. That hole is critical because it supports the little star rollover, which has to sit down flush after you put the new top in. Otherwise, it'll make the ball become airborne and it won't roll over the switch. You see how nice and smooth the hole here at the top still is. So the overlay will go on shortly. Our new beautiful overlay. We put a light underneath and we apply the overlay very carefully. It is not a one-man operation.
Yeah, calm down a little bit, not so.
It's a three-man operation. To get it exactly right, you have to line up all the holes. You can see the numbers are actually in the overlay material, and it's clear where it goes. And now the fun task. It's fun, right?
Yeah, tedious.
See, all those have to be carefully removed with a sledgehammer. That's how
you
I would
use your
do
head.
Yes.
Yes. It was quite a job.
This was one that was probably definitely destined.
And everybody had their hand dumpster. In this. Steven had his hand in it. My Tony had his hand in it. And my Jason. Where's Jason?
He's over there.
And then Chris worked on the boards. You worked on the. Everybody had their hand in this game. Look at it. Looks like new. New plastics. New drop targets. New pop bumper caps.
And start chalking.
And it talks. And look, isn't this nicely laid out? The red up top, green light. It was actually a bulb directly behind a socket to light that light. Isn't that nice? Look at that. See? Now that one, you can see, is a frosted one. And then these are all super brights. Very colorfully laid out. Look, Frank's new board, which he's putting in production. We're going to have this available. Was it going to be like 10 bucks, Frank, or something? Or under that, right?
About 10. I'm waiting for them to come in from the manufacturer.
Yes, we're going to have the board with a built-in diode, so you don't have to worry about unsoldering the diode. This will plunk, it'll solder right in your original holes, won't it, Frank, when we get the
supply. It'll come with the battery.
And it'll come with the battery. And you can buy the battery anywhere. So you'll be able to update all of your old Bally games and get rid of that stupid remote board.
Those are coming in the one for the Williams, the AA replacements. I have both of them on order.
Look, driver board has the new caps here. We flip the fuse so it takes a standard size. You can do that with your game. That little creepy fuse is hard to get. So you take the fuse holder out, flip it around using the original holder, and then it's just soldered on one end. It will be fine for the rest of your natural life. A new all-tech board for the lamp driver. Our EEPROMs were reburned for the game. New capacitors, too. We changed all the capacitors and new volume pots. This has been super bulletproofed. Frank, you changed a lot of the connectors. That's a new connector. The original connectors were like this, with the cap on them. We never liked them. we always liked the old connectors with the pins. You can buy all that stuff from Marco's Specialties. He sells the whole, it's wonderful. He has the plugs, the pins, the little pins that go inside.
They'll fix
so
many problems.
We buy tons of them from Marco. So he has all that stuff. And of course, Steve Young stocks other, lots of other parts. Steve has the drop targets, the pop upper cap. The plastic sets, I don't know where we got them from, but look, the new plastics are protected forever with Alexan washers. They will never, ever, ever break. Unless, of course, you put it in an arcade where it got 1,000 plays a week. Then after about, 50,000. I don't know, 50,000? Somebody in an earlier video didn't understand why the lights were out. You build these up. These carry over from game to game. That little battery holds that in the memory. So every time you spell, get all the targets in, you spell the deluxe, you spot another letter. When you get to the very end, see the E? You win a free game. Now that's adjustable. Have a color changer here. That was a nice little extra touch. Now, the overlay is almost perfect. It's not absolutely perfect in terms of lining up to the holes. But boy, it sure beats a lot cheaper for this overlay than buying a new wooden play field. In my opinion, it was worth doing. Especially when you play as well as me.
Which is more than all.
We got one last adjustment.
That was great. How'd that work out for you?
Now we had new caps. All three pop uppers have been rebuilt with all new parts. All that's been done. Guy's driving down from Highbridge to pick this up. He's actually not having a stroke, Frank. He's not having a stroke. He's coming down Saturday, and it's only Friday. We got it done the day before he's coming down. I think this came out very nice. And now we are going to take you back and show you a jukety box. Let's go.
R93.
This is the R93. You caught me before I got a chance to finish it. Now, this is beautiful. Now, so happens that this machine still has the CD player in it. So we're leaving that in there. It still works. Some people. Now there's got to be a good song in this, right? 105. Isn't that beautiful the way that spins? And look at the three-dimensional look of this panel. If you move up and down, because they have it folded in and out, and it's lit very, very effectively. Very nice. Now the tone arm is on this side of the machine. Have you noticed that mostly it's on this side, tracking this way? So the record's still spinning in the same direction, but the arm is mounted backwards. So because of that, the needle and cartridge are mounted backwards. All of the Rowe jukeboxes use that Shure cartridge with the diamond needle. Oh, by the way, the blue means it's diamond. On these jukeboxes. Light blue. If it's any other color, it means it's. This could be hell.
This is hell.
That sounds. This is an R93. Look at how quickly it dumps the record. Isn't that nice? Great box, flutes, and then our CD player is below. That's the Pioneer Home Player. And of course, right inside here, we've reheated the amplifier, we reheated the power supply. Everything is as good as new, as to be expected. Oh, and a new lithium battery in the back. So!
You gotta be scraping your boogies off it for a month.
That was a dry sneeze, Frank.
Like your jokes are dry.
Now look!
This beautiful piece is going out. Another Genesis. We took some creative license with this, but we've got chrome T-molding here. That's that wonderful new back glass that man makes. Of course, that's the Metropolis robot, which just so happens to look just like the robot down below, and nobody ever really realized that. Now, we have super brights throughout the whole machine, a little different than the other machine we did, because now we have the tower LEDs that we're using to light the play field. See the little towers? Okay. And we've drilled two holes here. Actually, Tony did. And he put two extra blue lights below that light these plastics. Isn't this nice looking? God, it's beautiful. We think the guy's going to be very happy. And of course, it does have the ramp protectors to keep us. The only thing we noticed, and we actually thought it was kind of neat, sometimes when you hit the flippers, the LED flash lamps have a little blink. And it was really sharp. It was actually kind of neat. Down the toilet. Now, this game has a lot of adjustments. If you put it on easy, if you spell anything, you'll spot a letter in all the targets. If you go down here, so this way I'm only spotting one letter. But you can flip a switch, and when you do it, it spots one letter in every single thing. It's too easy. You don't want to make these games too easy. So we have the game set on hard, which is a good way to set it. Isn't it, Frank?
You like it hard.
Frank, do you know how many of these we sell?
Let me check my list.
I don't remember either.
To my pocket, hold on.
This is how many. This is the, so when we sell this, when we deliver this today, that's how many. Not bad. But guess what? It is time for us to go up front because it's Tony's going away party. My Anthony, he's got another job. He hates us. He's leaving us for good. Actually, he's going to come back on the weekends and at Christmas. At least he says he is. They all say that, though, don't they, Frank?
They come back 1 or 2 days, and that's the end of it.
Then we never see them again.
What's the common denominator in that?
Oh. Me? I thought it was the money factor. I think $8 an hour is pretty damn ass good money.
When did you raise everybody's pay?
I had to raise it to keep it, you know, keep up with the minimum wage, which we don't pay. By the way, that speaker has to go in.
Oh, there it is. Put it in.
You better put it in.
Let's go.
Yeah. Ah! They're back!
Well, there's food here. Of course they're back.
They're here. They're back in time to eat. All right, let's go up front, gentlemen. Ah, it's very quiet here, Tony. Not much activity, just munching. Jonathan, did you sign that man's card? No, he didn't. They're making quick order of the pizza. Pam, what should I have? You can bring the broccoli. Uh-huh. The full treatment, right, Tony? We had to persuade him to try the mousse cake. Tony, we've carefully selected that card.
Very carefully. Thank you. It
was the Nadal bit.
Pay no attention to the white. But it was not reused.
Oh, that's horrible. What are you doing, filming me?
No, the camera's pointing at you with a red light.
It says, good luck, Tony.
It used to say Ryan, but we switched it.
Well, anyways. Well, we had to reuse it. He's laughing at his own wretched joke. Let's put your cake back in, Tony. Now, don't we all wish this man good luck in his new job?
Well, not my money if he likes it.
It pays a lot more money than I can. But Tony has lots of little ones to raise.
Thank you very much.
He'll be able to take his cake home and feed the family and relatives for weeks. Nope, they won't be filming. He's going to be
installing air conditioning systems and heating systems, right? A union job that pays big bucks. Well, there's a big difference now, Jonathan. Beautiful new side art, new T-molding. Got the front door all beautiful, don't you, young man? It's all been repainted. Jonathan, a smile would help.
What?
A smile, young man?
Yeah.
Yeah. He's cross. He's cross with me. This guy is screaming. Anyway, the new style, of course, as you saw earlier. Actually, you didn't. Let's go to see what this looked like first. Now, Wallace called me back here. Wallace, what did you want to show me about this Miss Pac-Man?
Well, this thing here, it's messed up on the bottom. It's all broken. You got the original shipping block.
Oh, let's look. Tilt it over. Let's look. So, in other words, this person was so anxious to get this in location, so anxious that, yep, he never put the casters on the bottom.
And one plate is missing, isn't it?
There's a plate missing. Two, yeah. Actually, no, not a plate, but the...
Ain't that the hole the casters in?
Nope. Oh, yeah, yep, that is. It's missing. There's the shipping blocks, and you know what else is on the bottom, Wallace? Yeah. It's the side wall of another Miss Pac-Man.
Oh, well, you might need it to fix this one.
Isn't that luck?
And on the side here, it's peeling.
Oh, in a big way.
Okay, it's peeling off.
Yep. So, yep, this is that. This is the third run of Miss Pac-Mans. They were selling so well. You always know you have a third run because it has this white border around. The problem was the lovely glue they used to glue the...
It ain't holding too good.
It sure isn't. But you know what? When we put the new art on this...
Yeah, it'll be better.
It's as smooth as a baby's... Or what do you call it? Buttery?
Buttery smooth. Buttery smooth.
Now
this
also...
It would be more better, yes. As they say.
Now look, the other thing is, what difference is... It uses the large transformer on the down on the bottom from like this. Spy Hunter actually had more stuff on it. But the later transformers, and everything's in the cage to make it compliant with those FCC folks. Yeah. They had to put everything in the cage.
It'll have to rebuild the list.
Yeah, that'll have to be fixed. Yeah, Wallace, you got your work cut out. This guy's having a stroke.
Yeah, so am I.
Hey, Wells, what day is it?
This is Saturday. This is going to be our short day.
Well, you better start working. And what's that in your nose, young man?
Don't you worry about me.
You got two guys that don't even work on Saturday. And you got two guys that work on Saturday, and you're killing us.
Now, how come the bulbs aren't screwed in? Or actually the bubs?
You ain't got enough guys here.
Oh, can I reach them, Wells?
We ain't got enough gas.
Oh! No, it fell out. The bulb fell out. Wasn't that Miss Pac-Man gorgeous? We only do the best work. Now, Witch & Co., your beautiful mug. Can you hear it? Listen. Isn't that neat? The national anthem. I gotta put some milk in that. When you set it down, it goes off. Convenient, right, Frank?
Mm-hmm.
Fat-free milk. You know, Frank, why I have fat-free milk.
No, why?
To lose weight.
How's it working out for you?
Look, we did some decoding. The real mildly salty hind looper diamond drop. With the purchase of mildly salty hind looper, you prove to be a true lover of licorice. Isn't that nice? Licorice. And this one, drop with history. The real fruit, full sweet ship knots drop. And then that means now more content. Okay, and this is Stroop syrup cakes. Since 1883, and that's the brand. The Davilar is the brand name. Syrup cakes. Boy, they look good. I have to try this coffee. Wait a minute. This is the most amazing aroma I've ever. Listen, nobody has entered my contest. I only had one guy try the contest. Contest video is still live. Nobody understands. Tell you what, I'm going to give you all a clue. Look here. This is video 1108. Not once, but two different places I have the letter hidden. Look at this.
Oh, sorry. Wallace complains I put my coffee mug in. Anyway, Ron,
happy birthday. Number two, Ron would love to meet you and the crew. Is there any way you can do this, and how? That's good. And the second place is just a minute later. Here it is. And now we're ready for you. This way.
We are going to show you.
Come on. You've got to uncover my contest video. One man has found five of the letters. That was one of the five. So I figured I'd make it easy for you. We're going to have to try these, Frank, in another video. Enter the contest. There's the link right there. Okay? When the contest is finished, we'll take the link down. In the meantime, thank you, Mr. Van Helden from Holland, or the Netherlands.
Good night. Now clear out!